Minecraft Skyblock has some insane recipes, and if we type slash recipes, there is a few that stand out. Emerald Mob Coin Gen Shard, Gold Mob Coin Gen Shard, Coal Mob Coin Gen Shard. And what this is essentially you put mob coin generators in a crafting GUI. You put one in every single slot, so that's 9. And then you get one of these. And it can be used to craft a super version of that type of mob coin generator. So I want to go ahead and at least craft a super mob coin generator today of any type. If we go into PV4, I have 8 coal, 5 gold, 6 emerald. And if we get one more mob coin generator in the coal tier, we can make a super generator. I already have 2 currently for emerald. I do want to set up a farm area because I had to destroy for the gas farm. I had to destroy the mob coin generator area. Basically, what that means is we need to find an area that we can put super mob coin generators down. The problem with the regular ones is when you have too many of them, it can cause your game to lag. So the super ones make it so you get more mob coins while lagging very little. It's a good trade-off. It just takes time to get the super one. You can see the difference on the emerald one. I get 1 every 4 minutes and 30 seconds. On the super, I get every 4 minutes and 30 seconds. I get 200. What is a big difference? Let's go ahead, get some deep slate bricks, purchase them up, and let's turn on chunks to see what we're working with here. So I found the edge of the chunk here, and what we're gonna do is have hoppers going down. So I'm gonna buy a stack of chests or more. I think more is probably a better option. So I wanna make it so the mob coin gens are in this chunk with the alt, but then the loot gets transferred to this chunk over here. That is pretty much the go-to plan. We're gonna make the mob coin gens on this line right here. So we need to go ahead, grab them out. And I guess we'll put 2 down for now, because that's all we have. And then we need hoppers very quickly here. So let's go ahead, grab some hoppers. We are going to need a few stacks of these. So I got a few stacks of hoppers. Now we need to go ahead, make a layout here. And then we're gonna put hoppers feeding this way. Now I need to place blocks here, and we'll have a hopper facing down, and we'll put 2 different ways that this will go so then it doesn't overflow as often. Just doesn't have any issues, of course. That's the plan I want for it. So all I have to do now is make a chest system going down about this far, I think is the plan. On each side though. It'll go right to the edge of the chunk because that's just the easiest option. So that should mean we have, I think, 16 of these chests in one row. So let's go ahead, do it on the other side. The reason we're making the chest system different from how the other chest systems are for the farms, because I want the mob coins to actually flow down to the very bottom if I take out of the bottom chest. It's just more convenient. So what I'm doing is actually fixing the mob coin generator area because I messed up the hoppers. I'll give a rundown of what I just fixed here in a moment. So let's place the mob coin gens down, and then we're gonna have hoppers feeding this way, of course, and then hoppers feeding this way. Then of course we have hoppers feeding along here. Okay, so I had to fix it so where all the items would go down a specific path, like go to one spot first. That is basically all I wanted. I needed hoppers facing down under the row. So now I need to place a ton of chests down. One thing I'm doing is placing the chests manually because using Lightmatica the first time when building is kind of weird, like getting a little part of it. So let's say this row of chests and then just moving it down a ton would just take longer than actually building it manually the first time. And if I build it manually the first time, then I can copy the whole thing for another time when I need to use it. So realistically, I think this is the better option, and then I'll copy this whole design when I'm done. Okay, so half of the chests are done. Now we have to do this side. So from what it seems, setting up the rest of these are actually very simple. I'm not having really any troubles placing these. And then we have to go ahead, put the hoppers down, and we should be good. One thing we're forgetting is also we need to make the whole mob coin generator, so we have to make that as well. But let's go ahead, start placing down these hoppers on the backside here of all the chests. And so that means we can actually fill the loot to the very bottom of these. So let's go ahead and get this going. Okay, so all the hoppers are done. So we're done the layout. We just gotta wait and see if this flows properly in the system with these mob coin generators here. They should be spawning in about 5 seconds. There we go, 200 and another 200. So it picks them up instantly and then they flow into the right spot. And the good thing about this design is I can just make it expandable on the back. I can just keep adding more generators over time if I really need to. Really quickly, I'm gonna pick up these generators so I can schematic this. So give me one moment. Okay, so I finished up getting the schematic. Now we're just gonna go ahead, place these down, and we're gonna try and buy a coal mob coin generator off of someone. So one of the helper's little cart is gonna give me a coal mob coin generator for free. I was gonna go ahead and buy one, but I mean, it is what it is. I appreciate it. There we go. A little cart just gave me the mob coin generator, the cool one. I appreciate it nonetheless. So we're going to go ahead, go to PV4, and we're going to grab out all these mob coin generators here and the gen shards. Now we're going to go ahead, do slash craft, or just use a crafting table. And we're going to go ahead and now combine that. And then we're going to make a super mob coin generator. And it's for coal. So every 45 seconds, I get 200, what is absurd. So I'm going to give it one dedicated side of this whole thing. And then this side will just be for all the emeralds. But every 45 seconds, I'm going to be getting 200 coal mob coins. But I mean, they're not the best mob coin, but I mean, that's a ton. It's going to overflow this thing like crazy. And it makes my FPS slightly better. I mean, all these chests are not helping my FPS. I would be at like way more if I was further away, but the chests are just chunking my FPS down like crazy. So there we go. We got our super mob coin generator farm complete, and I can't wait to expand on this. Let's go.